Okay, Vlogmas Day 17, Take 2. Anyways, I have no idea how people can vlog with glasses and not get glare. Especially with a phone, it's just not possible because of the screen just reflects off your glasses. Anyways, I'm halfway through a movie and I stopped watching it because I'm having a little bit trouble focusing on it today. Yeah, anyways, my attention span's a little bit shorter than normal today. It's called Come Play, and it's from 2020, and it's about an autistic kid who's being sought after by a monster that's kind of like Slender Man. Actually, it's extremely like Slender Man, but it's communicating through his phone and his tablet and stuff like that. It's trying to get him to read the stories, because if he reads the story all the way through, he can come through and steal the kid, of course, you know. it's kind of a weird movie, but it's worth watching, I think, so far. Anyways, so far it's about a 6. It's not really that fast paced. It's not really that exciting, but it'll hold your interest enough that you should be able to get through it and be entertained by it. I'm pretty sure it'll pick up by the end. They usually do. Movies like this usually pick up more toward the end, so I might like it a little bit more by the time I'm done. Anyways, I made a whole bunch more puzzles, even though I said I wasn't going to make any more, and I probably shouldn't, because I've got too many of them to survive the attempt of finishing them. I will be long dead before I go through all the puzzles that I have created for Jigsaws Galore on my PC. It's just, it's not possible for me to live long enough to get through them all. There's just too many of them. Anyways, I've got exactly the not safe for work ones. I've got exactly 1,000 of them so far. 56 of those are things that nobody else can have if they wanted them. I wouldn't give them to them because they're for me only. They're from somebody from somebody that I know, and it's like a no-go for trading those ones. Not like I trade them anyways, because I don't know anybody that plays the puzzle thing in town, so, and nobody's online has wanted to trade the puzzles, and it's not like it's worth sending them, because you can make your own, right? If you got the program, you can make your own puzzles, so why bother? Anyways, there's 1,000 of the not safe for work ones. There's exactly 3,000 now. I made sure there was exactly 3,000 because I wanted to be exactly 3,000 of the ones that I've made myself, and with pictures that I found on the net and pictures that I've taken and my own art and stuff like that, you know. And there was 440 original puzzles that either came with the program or were free to download from the website. There's a section in there with free stuff that you can download. Anyways, there was 440 of those exactly. So there's 4,440 puzzles that I've got on there. Like I say, I'm keeping the ones that I've finished in a separate folder. I remove them from the list, from the folder, and I put them in an archive, a zip archive, to have them in case I ever want them again. I don't know why I'm keeping them, but I am. I just want them, damn it. So, you know. Anyways, yeah, it's I love the program. It's not that expensive, and it has given me hundreds of hours of fun over the years. I've had it since the previous version, which was version 6, I'm using version 7 now. 7.29, I do believe, is the version, the latest version. And it's quite fun. There's only been one bug that I can report for it ever. It doesn't seem. My render's finished. It's been hours and hours, and the shadow just finished rendering. Anyways, there's only one bug that I can report for Jigsaw's Galore on the PC. Anyways, it does not like photos taken by an iPhone, and I don't know why. I used to have an iPhone years ago. And I didn't like the iPhone. I'll tell you that. I do not like the interface. I did not like iPhone at all. I did not like that thing. I just did not. Anyways, and I never looked back after going Android. So anyways, but it didn't like the photos that I had taken with my iPhone. It didn't like them at all. And I tried photos that another person had taken with a more recent iPhone, and it didn't like them either. It crashes. It literally crashes when it doesn't hard lock or anything. It just goes boop and dies, basically. when you try and make a puzzle out of an iPhone picture, and I don't know why, but oh well. There is an actual Mac version of the program, and I'm sure that it does iPhone photos because, you know, it's made on a Mac. So I don't think it's the same version number. I don't think it's 7.29 or something like that. I think it's a different version number for the Mac one. I'm not sure because I don't have a Mac, but yeah, anyways. So, other than that, it works fabulously every time. You can have up to 10,000 pieces, I do believe. I think it's 10,000 pieces. As little as 4 pieces and as much as 10,000 pieces for the puzzle. I don't know what 10,000 pieces would look like because you'd have to have a 4K monitor. You couldn't do it on a 1080p anyways. They'd be too small. You wouldn't see them. You'd have to have a big monitor too. So my 22 inch, my 21.8 inch, that is, monitor, I really don't think you would be able to get the pieces together on it, because it wouldn't be big enough. They would be just way too small. I've done one that's an 800 piece that I made, and it took me a long time to do, and it was really hard because there was just so many pieces. They're not all on the screen at the same time either, because there's too many of them, so they're not all on screen at the same time, and you have to do it in pieces after you have a certain amount of pieces, so you have to do the puzzle in sections. So anyways, other than that, it snowed today, and it was minus 20 again today. It snowed a little bit. It didn't snow a lot, just enough to make it more slippery and more dangerous outside for me to walk around. So there's a lot of ice on the ground because it thawed out, then it froze, and then it thawed out and it froze. So there's a lot of ice on the ground, and now there's a fresh layer of snow on top of it, and that's never good. Not for people like me, anyways, that are. If I fall, I get really hurt, and it's going to be extraordinarily hard, if not impossible, for me to get off the ground if I fall. So, you know. Anyways, the fractals I've rendered today were IFS fractals. They're not the usual ones that I do. They're kind of round and bulbish and little balls with texture, and they're really quite nice. You can go to my art site. It's linked in my profile. and the about section of my profile, you can find the link to my art page. Anyways, you can go look at them if you want to, if you care to. If you don't, that's fine too. I don't care. Anyways, art's getting popular. I'm not super popular like some of the furry artists that I follow. Some of those people have like 20, 30,000 followers, and that's wild to me. Anyways, fractals aren't very popular an art form, but I super like them, and I like doing them, and I like looking at them, and it's just something that I really enjoy. Anyways, y'all have a fabulous day, and keep smiling, and happy Vlogmas. We're getting closer to Christmas, yo.